Pritchard yet?
I'm right here, Jensen, staring at a blueprint of the Tai Yong medical building.
Great. I need access to a security terminal in the upper city tower.
You do realize there's an entire skyline between you and it, don't you?
I know. The Pangu. Any idea how I get to it?
I suggest you start by going up.
What's up, ladies and gents? I'm your host, Sunshine01. Welcome back. This is going to be a fun episode for you guys. Lots of stealth in this video, so hopefully you guys will enjoy it. Picking up pretty much where we left off, we took the train over here to Tai Yong Medical. Lots and lots of cool stuff to be done in this video. Very excited, as this is going to be one lengthy video, as well as lots of fun times to be had by all. So we're going to go ahead and get into this. I'm not going to rush my way through, but I am going to show you some cool tricks to get around some of these guys pretty easily. And hopefully you guys will enjoy. And first things up is we need to hack into here so we can get into this place. Alright, we can't get to the bad guys, but we do have one of those that we can pick up, so it should be pretty easy.
Access granted.
Alright, we picked up a nuke virus. We have no stops, but we have a bunch of nukes. So, there are going to be some augments that we are going to be picking up in this level. The reason that we're going to be picking them up is there's a few augments we need in order to get by certain sections, and it'll be a good time to pick them up. But like I said, I've always been picking them up on the way of whenever we actually come to the point that we really need them, so.
Enough with the play-by-play. What do you need?
There's a valve. In the next move, you have to close it.
I'll see what I can do.
Oh, thank God. Please hurry.
So there's actually two things you can do. You can go in here and you can do this method here where you are just hacking the code. Or you can go to the back room, which is a level 1 hack, but you have to have a certain augmentation in order for you to breathe. We can't get to the bad guys, so let's just go ahead and start this. As soon as we have any problems, we will start fortifying. But this is something that's definitely going to be... Crap. Oh, I hit the wrong button. Sorry, I hit right mouse instead of left mouse. Alright, let's do this again. Luckily, we're still good to go. So... let's see, we'll go ahead and do 2, up to 40.
Access granted.
We didn't get any extra things, but no worries, and we were able to accomplish it. Pick up this here. And there you go. We don't want the gas grenade, we just want the chit. Let's go in and talk to him here.
You saved my life. How can I repay you?
You can give me some directions.
To where?
I need to get to the upper tower.
You must use the elevator pass to cryo sterilization room. But unauthorized personnel unallowed up there. But Kim is the guard on duty today. He owes me a favor. Just tell him Lee sent you, and he should let you through.
Much appreciated, my friend.
The least I can do. You saved my life. Not many people would have done that here. I cannot tell you how grateful I am. Thank you.
So because we actually talked to him, now you could save his life and then not come over here and talk to him, but because we talked to him, we're going to be able to get by the next section without having to bribe the guard, which makes things a little bit easier. Again, if you want to stealth your way through it completely, of course, You can, but if the game allows us to find a unique way around it, that's what we're going to do. So I'm going this way because there's some another thing that we can hack here. This is the level 1 door that you can hack for good experience points. So you might as well, just to kind of get your hacking level expertise up. We can't get to it, but it looks like it's a pretty easy one as far as getting to where we need to go. It's as simple as going bam and bam. But if we can get in here and we can grab this guy, then that would be great too. Looks like we're gonna get a nuke.
Access granted.
Sweet. And looks like that's pretty much gonna be it for right here, so.
Where do you think you're going, buddy? This is a restricted area.
Now, the option on the bottom would not be there unless you saved Lee. So your options would be bribe, bluff, and intimidate. So we're gonna mention Lee.
Lee didn't warn me that I might be refused entry. I guess he figured you'd remember the favor you owe him and let me by.
Right, look. I'll let you pass because I do owe him. But watch out for the security systems. If you get detected, I'll have no choice but to take you out.
Fair enough.
Alright, so that, of course, leaves you. It makes him actually go into here, so he doesn't actually see anything that you do in here. Whereas if you didn't do that, then he would be moving kind of throughout this area, and you would have to worry about him and other guards. But the guards are still guards that you need to kind of to worry about. There's security systems and things like that. Obviously, this is a huge section, but it's actually pretty easy to get through. We need to get actually. I think is it straight down? No, it's right over there, right on the other side where that camera is. Is the door, but there's a lot of stuff in here that you're able to kind of mess with. So to start it out, you want to hack this panel here. It's a security level 2. It's okay to hack it. They won't be mad at you or anything. We can't get to the node, or we can't get to it. Let's see, where are we going? Up, 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 down, and down. This sucks because I wish I had a stop, but I don't have any stop. But we've got our detection pretty much up as high as we need it to be, so it's not too bad. And we got, looks like, plenty of time.
Access granted.
And we got a stop worm. Nice. Alright, but do not move it. Right now you can see the platform is right there. So don't move the platform just yet. Nothing to pick up there. We're going to get a few goodies. There is a lot of, like, unique routes that you can take to get to your objective. Let's see, we got a few things to pick up here. We got, is that a nuke? And, no wait, that's not a nuke, sorry. That's an ebook. Did you guys read that? Crossbow. I've never used the crossbow in this game. I wonder if it's any good. We have a pocket secretary here. Let's go ahead and read some of our pocket secretaries since they offer codes. Access code to the pump room. And some storage units. So, good information to add, you know. Now we can actually move it. Again, if you're looking for a speedrun, you can always go check out someone else's. This is never my intention to do speedruns on here. I think this is the same one we probably already read. It's my intention to be as informal as possible while showing you some cool things. But we're going to go ahead and use this. As you can see, it's going to reposition and allow us to take another area, which has a vent that we're going to be going through to get inside the access room now. So there is also other ways that you can get to said access room. Like, there's also another vent that will take you around and through. There's just so many different, you know, cool routes that you can take here. As you can see, you can go down the stairs here, and you don't have to worry about any guards right here, right now. You can see there's a boiler room here with an access to security room 3. Nothing really important for you to get in there, but if you want to, hey, by all means, go ahead. Some more access stuff down there. Ooh, nice. Another nuke. Might actually have to start using these nukes here sometime. As I said, you know, you can go this way. Go along that way. Like I said, there's plenty of different opportunities and different ways for you to go. But we're going to take the vent route. Grab ourselves a nice little traveler bonus. There's two vents routes that you can take. And they both lead you to roughly the same area. One is inside the room, the other is just outside the room. Yeah, that's right. If you come over here, you can pick up a sniper rifle. That is a kill sniper rifle, that's not a tranquilizer rifle. We got Pathfinder here too, so you can see why. I don't know why that just picked that up. But we'll go ahead and look at it and see. I think we're already pretty much full. We don't really need it. Eh, whatever. Here we go. So far, no slowdowns or lag, and I probably just jinxed myself. But if you actually look at this, compare it to the normal version, you can see that it's just so much prettier to look at. Now, obviously, you can't use this method unless you have the Icarus landing system, unless you grab a fire extinguisher and you drop it right in front of you and you like kind of ride its tail down. Then you're able to go down here without worrying about anything else. So here is where you're going to want to save, because this is where some enemies are going to be located and all that kind of stuff. There's all kinds of things that you can get in here, but it's nothing that is detrimental to the story or anything like that. And we are mostly and mainly following a type of story. So I'm going to go ahead and save here.
Sentries. I heard they installed some in the upper tower, too.
Yes. Laser detection checkouts will be run by sentries from now on. They'll be able to neutralize intruders. You know, these mean, huh? We're all...
And this is all you have to do. Boom. You're able to get by this whole area. And that's pretty much it. But there are a few things that I want to, like, look around, I guess. Mainly for shits and giggle reasons. As you can see, you can't get up there unless you have the jump ability. So what I'm actually going to do is go ahead and grab that, because that is actually something that is pretty good to have. That should be as far as your legs go. We've got 9 praxis kits, so there's some things that we can go ahead and get. Having this is pretty good. It costs 2, but I think it's definitely worth it. The run and silently sprint faster thing is not really something that we need. I guess I'll go ahead and pick up. Let me tell you which ones that we're going to be getting here. The one that we were going to get before, but we didn't, when we did the Barrett boss fight, which is something that has to do with hacking turrets. Disable turrets linked to security hubs or turn them against their allies. Turrets and robots and things like that is always something... that you want, as well as disabled linked security hub. So we're gonna grab these two. You have to get both of them in order to do it. And like I said, we've got plenty. Might as well go ahead and grab this. We're gonna want to hack level 5. And now you can see we can actually get up in here. This is strictly for like traveler bonuses, to show you some unique ways. Under the sea. Pathfinder, 300 XP, which, you know, definitely helps out for getting more praxis kits, so it kind of pays for itself. And I'll show you where it takes us. See? Suspicious, don't worry. Suspicious is nothing. That's just the camera or whatever. But it's not not a problem. Suspicious doesn't hurt you in any way. We're just on the other side of where we were before. So we're going to head back down. And you always know whether or not how good you are if you go to a new section. And if it says ghost, then that means that you've been going through... if you get the two stars, the two gold stars, that definitely means that you have went through and you should be fined. And you don't have to worry about it not unlocking your achievements in the end. Excuse me. Alright, so let's make sure we're good to go. See where this guy is here. You can see he's coming across right now, so we're going to wait. So all that was is right over there. Now you notice that there's only one guard down here. Normally there's two patrolling. The reason that there's not two is because we were able to get by the guard because of Lee. He doesn't go down here if you don't mess with him or if you use Lee as a distraction. So, yeah, kind of helps you out a little bit. Magically appeared. You can actually hack these alarm panels. And we're good. Alright, we're going to go ahead and go on now. You can see we got a guard there. It's a risk, but I'm not going to take it. He's going to be turning around here any second. Like I said, you don't need to go into every single room, and that's not my purpose. There are so many like videos out there of people like showing you every nook and cranny, but I do want this to be a decent walkthrough showing you some cool routes to go, but nothing that's too like kind of just wasting your time. Nothing really in there. It's unlocked anyway, so there's nothing actually really in there either. Nothing that you 100% need. Like, I'm only gonna go to the places that are gonna be helpful for the story to help you guys figure things out, and things that we actually really need. Yes, they give you experience points for getting other things, but nothing too big.
Pritchard, I'm in an elevator leading to the Bangu. Any security features I should know about ahead?
Nothing too taxing, I suspect. The Pangus use mostly for maintenance and storage. Look for a second elevator once you're there. It'll carry you straight into the tower.
Alright. So this is still technically a part of this area, so we're not to the next section just yet. But there are no guards up here, but you can see that we do have that we have to worry about. Now, if you have... There's actually an augmentation that allows you to walk on electrified, but you actually don't have to worry about it because... But you're Adam Jensen, and you're pretty smart. Let's pick up whatever we need here. Okay, this is going to be a long video because there is a lot of areas and a lot of cool things to go into here. So, let's say if you didn't want to be a security, like you didn't have security level 4, you can see there's how to turn off the electric. Just talking really fast. Electricity. There's a way to get into that room. You can see the vent there. So you've got this. Stay away from the electrocution. This is a horrible area. Look at this. There we go. Finally, it loaded in. You can use your jump to jump up there to where you don't have to worry about it, but you can actually go back here. You can see that there is a grate. And if you go this way, take you to where you need to go, and you can shut it off. And inside, easy peasy lemon squeezy. And of course, that's mainly to help you. Now we can also go this way. I wonder what that could be. Looks like there's a lot of good information that you need. So we're going to come back up through here as well before we head on. So now that we've unlocked or we turned off the electrical fencing, or the electrical little surge there. You can get up here. So you don't need to have the double jump or the higher jump in order to be able to do this. As you can see, you've got crates. You can use those crates to jump up to these areas, but now that we actually have superhuman jumping, as you can see, it actually helps us to, you know, maneuver about things a little easier, which will definitely come in handy a little bit later as well. So you can take a look at the beautiful skyline. We're right at the what separates the top city from the bottom city. Pretty cool stuff. So this is where you need to go. This is going to get you to your next area right there. But before we do that, there's a few things we're going to do. Obviously, you can only get in here if you've unlocked things that you can pick up. I'm going to pick up the stun gun darts. Looks like that's it. All right. There it is. Now, as you can see, this one's a little easier to get into, I think. just got to do it right. There we go. All right, again, you can only drop down here if you have Icarus, unless you can find a fire extinguisher. But this is very important to get in here, because look what we picked up, a tranquilizer rifle. And this is something that I actually want. I don't know if I can use this reload speed for the tranq rifle. I don't think so. We're going to find out right now, actually. Yes, we can. Awesome. We're going to keep this tranq rifle. Just because we've only... Actually, you know, I'm never planning on using, you know, the stun or tranq. But, I mean, you never know when you need it. It's something that you never know. Pick up that, obviously, if you want to collect that. Now, here's the thing. So, picking up this access card here is going to allow your life to be very, very easy. It's going to allow you to be able to go through the next area pretty much free of charge. So it's going to allow you to get all of the XP you need and everything like that without worrying about being spotted by guards or being seen by guards. Now, if you, you know, want more of a challenge, you can do it without getting picking up. So you can obviously just pick, you know, what you want to pick up, the secretary and the chit. However, I am going to pick up the access card, just mainly, well, there's another access card you can pick up too. You don't have to do this one, but I'm going to go ahead and pick it up because I want to make this as simplistic of a walkthrough as possible for all of you. I'm not worried, like, I do like challenges, and obviously this game is challenging enough with the way that I'm trying to play it while not taking out any guards whatsoever. And I add that, I add my own, you know, personal challenge to it. Therefore, that's why I decided to go ahead and do it this way. I don't know if I can jump up here. Yeah. And we just need to go back up, and we're going to continue on to the next part of the level. I'm still going to go around and get everything that I can that's worth getting. But I do hope you guys like my thoroughness, but I'm not, like, trying for any means to reach 100% of just everything, if you know what I mean. I just want it to be fun.
Jensen, what is it you're looking for exactly?
Some kind of surveillance recording. Van Bruggen said he stashed it on a server somewhere.
He must have meant the data core room. Very high security. It'll be a couple of floors up from where the elevator lets you off. But the first corridors you'll pass through will be public, so you might want to keep any weapons concealed.
Copy that.
All right, so that's how you pretty much know. You can see that you see the ghost there. And the smooth operator, so that tells you that you've completed that first whole section by yourself, and you've done it in a stealthy manner. So, as long as you see that, you know that your record for being completely stealthy is still safe. All right, we are free to walk around. What lets you know that you're free to walk around is you'll see green. Green people means that you don't have to worry about anything. You'll see that the right there, there's a green thing that you can see. Civilians don't show up, but
You
can hack the terminal if you want to. That's just so people can't call an alarm on you.
This is unacceptable. I need to get into Legion Lab immediately. Yes, I understand that I'm the one who lost my access card, but it's
see, it pays to listen.
The new one immediately. I have important deal.
Somebody lost his access card, so that means you're able to use it to get in.
Shit is right. Luckily, they're lighter than most vending machines. I honestly thought it was the end for a second. Death by a vending machine.
I
pointlessly tragic.
So, if you're going for a more combat style, and you don't want to do the turret thing at the end of the level, then, or the robot at the end of the level, you could probably take this guy down, take his weapon, and that'll probably really come in handy. So, as you can see, there's a lock in that room, there's a lock in that room, lots of really, really good things in each. And we got a beautiful city skyline here. This is the upper city. So it's definitely better made. You notice that actually there's a way to get up there. So if you've got the enhancements that I do, the jump enhancements, you can actually take this, you can move it over to here, jump up, and then jump up to get to the second floor, and you can actually bypass everything. And it's pretty cool. But what we're going to do right now is we're going to get in here. Cover your tracks a little. So, if you didn't pick up the access card because you didn't have the Icarus landing system, you can go in here and you can do the same. So, you can see there's an access card right there, as well as a computer. There's lots. I'll just pretty much tell you what's on these computers, because when I went through the level earlier, I went through every computer and checked out everything. It's just a lot of backstory as far as the people that work here. And that's really the gist that you get from all of these computers. It's just a lot of information about the people that work here. So there's really, you know, if you want to be that thorough and you want to dive yourself into the story even more, then obviously check all of those out. Remember, you're in green, so you don't have to worry about, you know, looking weird because you're doing all this. We have the outside in this area, you're completely 100% safe. You know, if you're in an area that you're not supposed to be in, when the enemies turn a different color like this. As you can see, they're still green right now, so once you would enter into that room, then they would no longer be green. Which means, you know, that they're enemies. But for right now, they're not. So this pretty much tells you right here that there is an access card in the security terminal, which we were just in. So if you didn't find it from that, now you find it from that, so good information to have. As far as everything else goes, one way to sneak in would be over here. So let's say if we went in here, let's say you didn't have the access card, or you wanted to be completely stealthy. This is security level 2, so you can go and hack this, get the experience points. Looks like we can get to it. Wow, they're all data stores too, so that's... I mean, that just getting the bad guy gets you pretty much everything, so lots of bonuses on that one. Pretty easy. But coming in here, yeah, we got computers that you can read. Some of them are always open. I'll let you guys read that. Don't forget, you can always check out some of the bookcases and things, but you'll see that there is a vent. This vent will take you in to where you need to go if you wanted to be the complete stealth master and you didn't want to, if you didn't find the access card, pretty much. But since I said that's not the plan that we're doing, is we can actually walk right through the front door. You can see you got cameras, so if you were being stealthy and let's say you wanted to take people out, you would need to get into that security room that we came in through the vent. That terminal in there will allow you to take out the camera so that the camera will not see you take out the guy. As you can see, it's open. There's a lot of really, really good things in here, so this is a good place for you to actually come inside and search around. Go ahead and read some emails here. Again, you just need to move those. If you can't move them, then that's how you can get back here. But if you're someone who loves Typhoon, you can pick up that. We've got a whole box of energy, whiskey to improve your... Actually, let's go ahead and take a whiskey. And this should fill me up to just about 200, right? So lots of great things that for you to use in this section. This will last actually for quite a while. The whiskey is very, very strong. I can't tell exactly what that is. Painkillers. All right, well, I think I'm pretty much good with what we got so far. And you can see, if you got in any trouble, this is where the security bot would come out, so... Let's head inside now.
Can't let you in. Access to the lab is strictly forbidden without a Li Gang access pass.
No problem. Here it is.
Seems in order. Sorry about giving you a hard time, but apparently there's some pretty heavy stuff going on in there.
No apology necessary. You're doing a good job, soldier.
I like stealth when you can do it in their face. I know it's not as challenging, per se, but I like stealth that allows me to go right through the front door where no one knows what my real intentions are, you know? I think that kind of stealth to me is more interesting than... Obviously, I also love getting in and being, you know, without being seen, but there's just so many different ways that you could play this game. When I mean ghost in this game on the walkthrough, I mean me playing this game without... taking any enemies down. That's pretty much what I meant. So that's meant for me by ghost. I know there's so many people have different meanings of ghost. Walking into a level, never being seen by the enemy. Right now, we're not an enemy to these people. So therefore, that is taken out of context. So when we are the enemy, it's not being seen by the enemy is what I mean by ghost. So when you would come into this area, this room is where you would come into that vent right there. We'll go ahead and hack this. Let's see. We can get to the note, and it's not that far away. As you can see, everything is soft because we've got hacking stealth. Got plenty of time to get to the bad guy, so...
Access granted.
Good information. Pick up an ebook here. Just a security office. There's nothing too important in there. Obviously, there's security guards in there. There is going to be a Hudero book out here that we can pick up. Alright, well, as far as everything that's in here that we need to worry about, remember, if we didn't do what we did earlier, we would have to stealth through this section. But it's kind of nice just walking around. And that's going to be about it. We're going to go ahead and head upstairs now. It's very easy to stealth. Once you come in here, you enter that room, then you can see this little area right here. Just get up against here. And if you do that, these guys will not see you. Just like this. Just like this. And make your way over this way. Nobody will see you. And then you can come up here. And you just have to worry about this guard and a camera. Pretty easy to get around. Like I said, it would be really, really easy to get around, so there's no... just wanted to let you guys know if you wanted to go the more stealthy route without using the card. And see, we got another section over here. This is where I showed you could jump up from the bottom floor, so you can actually bypass all of this stuff by getting up here, which is pretty cool that the game allows you to do that. However, you are going to want to enter some of these rooms. Security level 3 computer, like I said, just more basic information. However, what you do want... No guards patrol this area. What you do want to do is enter here. Yeah, if you hack that, she will, like, get alarmed. Not alarmed, but, you know, civilians can be annoying sometimes. You do want to get in here. You can read these emails here. But you want to get inside here, and you want to pick up something very, very important. A praxis kit. Always picking up praxis kits whenever you get the chance is very, very important. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and move on. So remember, you have an access card only to this area. So once you leave this area, then you are no longer safe. So search around. I think we are. Yeah, we already read that a bunch of times.
Molly McTavish of embezzlement. McTavish denied the allegations, but could not explain how millions of dollars in revenue ended up in his personal account. I'm sure it was just a clerical error, quipped Zhao Yunru, CEO of Tai Yong Medical, as transfer of ownership was officially declared. The purchase gives Tai Yong a significant increase in global market share. This is Eliza Kassan, reporting to you live
from Pikes TV. Another thing for you to hack right there. I love how you can hack so many things.
A lot of complaints about the temperature in the data core room.
Too hot?
No, too cold. I think there's too much air coming in from one of the vents.
I have it checked out.
That kind of gives you a little hint. You could use the vent. Alright, so that's the point of where you're no longer friendly. So as you can see right now, they're still in green because I'm friendly on this side and that side. But once you scoot over to this side, they're no longer friendly. So keep that in mind. Alright, you've got a level 2 security rating that you can get in there. We'll go ahead and do it. Like I said, nobody goes around these halls. And we do need to get some more hacking in. I know hacking can be boring sometimes, but this is a... Look at how easy this hack is. It's literally bam to bam. With only a 15% detection rating. That's only because we can actually get the bad guy.
Access granted.
Very easy hack. Oh, I got 100 credit chips. Read some more emails. Listen to some great tunes. Look, that's from Windmill. Remember, we need to get one of his emails. That's like our main purpose in here. There's where technically we're going to be going.
Stock had taken a dip earlier in the day as rumors began to circulate, accusing CEO Ollie McTavish of embezzlement.
Nobody minds.
McTavish denied the allegations, but could not explain.
Nah, we won't go and hack it. We don't really need.
Ended up in his personal account. I'm sure it was just a clerical.
Because I really don't want to sit there and have to take out a someone.
The purchase gives Tai Yong a significant increase in global market share. This is Eliza Kassan, reporting to you live from Pikes. To China,
take a shot there.
Details about a bold maneuver by Biotech Corporation.
Alright, that's going to be it for here. Let's go ahead and head to the data core.
Where do you think you're going? The data core room is for authorized personnel only. You're not going to get in there.
I was looking for the cafeteria. Sorry.
So you can see that that's where we technically need to go. So I'm wondering if you could just cloak yourself, like, somewhere outside there, have enough, and then just, like, kind of walk right on through. But you can see that there are many, many different ways around into that area. Here's one of them. Actually, you can cloak yourself at this point and go right through the lasers. That's one way. As you can see, they're still in green, and now the lasers come back on. So once they are out of the area, then the lasers will turn back on. So So, as you can see, he doesn't get close enough. So I'm going to go ahead and auto-save here. And we're just going to wait on him. Make sure this other guy's not looking. And there you go. My suggestion would be to wait on him to turn back around, because we do need to hack something, and if we were to hack it right now, it's definitely possible that he could turn around. I mean, it would have been close. You can see how much time we've had now, but it's a risk I don't really like taking. He's coming back now. Again, you could also get there through the security room. This is security level 4. So we can't get to the node, but we can get to there. It's actually not too difficult. And we got what we needed.
Access granted.
Good job. And we have made it in. As you can see, that's exactly where we needed to be. But like I said, you can also get there through the security door there. So this one is a doozy. All right, so I'm going to actually show you a few different methods here, because I always want to be as thorough as possible to you guys. So we're going to get our energy level all the way up. Now you see we got 3 full bars of energy, okay? What we're going to do is, from this point, as you can see, we're safe. We're actually going to go ahead and stand up. We're going to equip our camouflage. And I'm going to show you the easiest way to do what you got to do. Bam. We have accomplished the task. We have accomplished the mission. We have made it past all the lasers. That's how easy that it can actually be to get past all the lasers, right? If you take this method that I just showed you, this is the easiest method to get past the lasers. But we don't want to do that. Make it, you know, too easy. And you can see, well, we've got a few more, so why don't we actually head in here and see if there's anything that we'd even need to pick up in here. And it looks like we got Typhoon ammo, so for those of you that want Typhoon, you can probably get in there. I just want to check to see if there's anything of significance. Security level 2. This will probably turn off the lasers, would be my guess. So let's just do it for shits and giggles to see what we can get ourselves into. That's pretty easy.
Access granted.
So you would get a nuke virus. Anything important into here? Not really. You get some experience. The usual fare. There is, however, a pocket secretary in here. But it doesn't give you a password. So, yeah, so you can see how easy that was to actually get in there and do that. So we're not going to do that. That's too easy even for us. So we're going to load up the quick save that I just did. All right, so now that we're back in, we're going to go ahead and show you 2 different routes. One route is here, so if you have the jumping ability, you can jump over, maneuver down there, and you can get to the next part right there. But we're not going to do that. We're going to show you as if you do not have that ability. So if you do not have that ability, you want to use these things as cover. These they block pretty much where the lasers come from, so once it gets past a certain point, you can maneuver around. It's not too difficult to figure out, but I did spend a little bit of time here trying to show you guys, to me, to be the correct times in order to make it. So as you wait here, once this laser is past that point, then go. As you can see, you got very, very little timing to do it, but it is a way to get around it, and of course you're good. As far as here, there's a room you can go in there with a vent, which will take you to the room with all the guys, but no real reason to get in there. Here, pretty simple. Wait till it's past that point, then you can go this way. This one's a little bit more challenging, as it requires you to maneuver left and right. As you can see, there's a small window where it's nothing is kind of showing up in the way. So if you wait until the right time, which is now, stick to the left, now go to the right, as you can see, and you'll be able to make it. Here you've got a camera straight in front of you, so you know you can't go straight. But you do have a moment of opportunity if you go this way and up those boxes. You don't need a double jump for the boxes. So wait until that point of it's passed, and you should be good. Alright, so now you just have the camera you have to worry about, right? Like I said, you don't need a double jump for these. So watch out for the camera. So there is a security bot right on the other side here, so that's why the camera is very important for you to watch out. You can see where it is. If you were to, let's say, move the box, you'd probably get caught. But you can actually go around the box. And you're good to go. So that is obviously the stealthier way to go. You guys saw that there is a nuke virus inside that room if you want to use your cloaking to get in there. Otherwise, there's really no reason. If you go in there, just kill all the people, you can probably remove the lasers. Right there is a terminal for you to remove the lasers, but you probably have to shoot that in order to be able to do it, so I don't really see the point in it. But yeah, I just showed you the stealthier way, I guess, to get through. That was actually fun trying to figure out. This game always makes me think, and I love that. Kind of figure out the best routes to take and...
Pritchard, I'm retrieving Van Bruggen's evidence now. Is Sarif patched in?
Right here, Adam. I'm listening.
I just heard that your team is mobilizing in Detroit. Why wasn't I informed of this sooner?
Tactical assignments are not your concern.
Reed and her team have subdermal GPL implants. They'll be tracked. Kidnapping them was a mistake.
Montreal took care of that.
Forgive me if I don't put as much faith in our friend Eliza as you do. She's too erratic.
Your concerns are noted, but I would advise you to concentrate on your own assignments instead of interfering with mine. Namir out.
Boss, did you get that?
I heard. I just...
Megan and the others. They're alive.
We've got to stay focused. Zala's a residence at the top of the tower. It's off limits to everyone except her and her guards. Now get up there and find out what she knows.
Alright, so let's see how we did. Again, you can always check out after you complete a certain point. Ghost and Smooth Operator, good to go. So hopefully you guys are enjoying it so far. We don't have too much of the level left. I wanted this to be a nice long video for you guys. You can obviously get through this a lot quicker and smoother. Actually, I think... Did I take the right area? Yeah, I was gonna say, I think I took the wrong... I know, I'm an idiot sometimes. Sorry, I apologize. This one's pretty easy. Walk straight through. If you fail that, I mean, you're just like a complete noob. Because it's very, very easy to get, by. Although, says the guy who just went downstairs instead of going through the door. I know. Alright, looks like we're clear here. What do we got? Scritty level 3, why not? I like giving you guys meaty videos. We can get to the node, and it's pretty far away, so we should have plenty of time. And I used a nuke just to make sure I was faster. Remember, going in here grabs you all your bonuses that you would get, so that's the only bonus we would have got anyways. The Dutchman. Obviously, you guys know who that is. As far as that goes, that's the only thing that was really in here, huh? I do like the way this looks, though. Isn't that pretty cool? I don't see anything else. I do apologize if there are things that you clearly see that I miss. So you can hack that. This one's just straight in. Oh, it does. Oh, we'll go ahead. See what security level it is. 3. These are just fun to do, you know. Hacking these things are really fun. That's actually not too difficult. We just need to go there and then there. We might need to use a stop, but we got so many nukes. 30% protection, I mean, we should not get caught. But I usually have bad luck when it comes to that stuff, so. And I had to use the stop. That's all right, because we ended up getting a stop worm, so. Some more little information for you guys, and... Oh, we probably did miss something then. Let's see. Those drawers really look weird. Yeah, there are drawers. But nothing's in them, of course. Just my luck. Alright, so here we go. We got more stealth up, and let's go ahead and save, and let's do this. Alright, so we got a camera. One, I see two enemies. Security level 3. We can get to the evil dude, but he's pretty far away, so we should have time. So we go here, down, up, over, down. Remember, we don't need to pick anything else up before we're able to hack this guy. It will do pretty much everything.
Access granted.
Another big one here. We go. We can get to it, so we just go here, here, up, up, and over. Nice.
Access granted.
All right. So this is cool because we've got the turrets that we can turn off. So why don't we deactivate robots? There's no reason to mess with the robots right now. We turned the camera off and that was the biggest thing. Okay, so we do see the one guard up ahead. Two guards are both looking in this direction right now. He should be heading back here in a second. There he goes. Remember, we took the camera out. Kind of meeting up. He's heading back. Should see him there.
Details about a bold maneuver by biotech corporation Tai Yong Medical continue to emerge.
Alright, we've already seen that news. Alright, so we got a security office. You can see a vent there. See a door up there, but if you actually move this, this will take you over to that security office.
About what happened with the boss at the hive?
Did he choke out another big mouth?
Where's chicken? So we should go through the hive and this broad starts laughing at the boss. Like she never figured out that problem.
We're gonna bypass it, and I'm gonna use my cloak to sneak around them. There you go. There's not really anything too important. Remember, there was a guy that's in that room over there. I love this stuff. Look at that. So much lore and history that they've built around this, the Deus Ex series. And watch out for that. So you can see through that door there. So we'll go ahead and use... Alright, able to get by that. Let's read out this ebook. Remember, suspicious is nothing. So, two different ways into the room. One way is punch the wall. Another way is to get over to there. Go in here, read your emails. Gives you an access code to enter into that room. But, I think it would be better to actually enter the access codes as opposed to punching the wall. I mean, they know I'm here, in a way, but, I don't know. I just feel like if we're gonna be more stealthy, punching the wall is not gonna help. Get in there quick, and we made it. Nice. Again, like I said, the other option would be to punch the wall. Alright. Beautiful view here. Now we have got a really, really cool stealth part coming up.
Sarif, man.
Son of a bitch. Van Bruggen?
Just thought you'd wanna know. I survived that little surprise party back at the hotel. And I'm sailing away from this shithole as we speak. All because of you.
You wanna thank me? Forget you ever had this frequency.
I got a better idea. I'm looking at your bank account right now, and, you know, Sarif really ought to pay you more.
Van Bruggen?
No need to thank me, man. Just enjoy it.
So the only reason we got this was because we gave him a weapon. If you would not give Van Bruggen a weapon, then he would not contact you here and you would not get the extra $2,000. I do like how this mod gives you those shadows. Look at that. That's pretty cool. Alright, so we got some story elements coming up, then we have an escape sequence, which which is pretty cool. Not too difficult to get by, though. So you're going to want to set yourself up for success in this sequence. And in order to do that, you're going to want to go ahead and flip up this vent. The reason you want to go ahead and flip up the vent is if you flip up a vent when there are enemies inside an area and they can see the vent is flipped up, they'll come over and search. You'll make your life a little easier if you do it that way. Word to the wise. As far as anything, I don't think there's anything. Oh, we got an e-book here. So this is the head of Tai Yong Medical's office. Reporting to you live from Picus. Don't really need revolver ammo. Got a computer. And you'll see here is the other vent that we're going to need to get through. Inform me that it has successfully purchased rival corporation EnProtech of Scotland. We got a safe. Security rating 5. Let's take a look at it and see how hard it would be to hack. I'm going to get 2 attempts. You can get to the node, so we would have a total of 3 stops and some nukes. We got plenty of nukes here. Oops, sorry. If we need to use nukes, we'll use nukes. It's a 50% chance, so we're going to go ahead and nuke it. Since we're going to go for this guy, we're going to go ahead and nuke it. And this one we'll go ahead and do. There we go. Sources close to the multinational giant. Access granted. I just like not to have to use the stop. Those are the best. Nice. Pocket secretary. I know we've already read all these, but just so they don't show up new anymore. There's so many. As rumors began to start, all right, what do we got here? Targeting system, I don't think is going to be anything that we need, but we'll find out. What can we use it with? Nope, you can't. So we'll drop that, because we don't need it. Let's see what she's got on her computer. I'm sure it was just a clerical error, quipped Zhao Yunru, CEO of Tai Yong Medical. All right, so we can get to the node. So here. The purchase gives Tai Yong a significant increase in global market share. This is Eliza Kassan reporting. If we get caught, we'll just do some defensive stuff, but looks like we're going to be good. To China now as details about a bold access granted. Biotech corporation Tai Yong Medical continue to emerge. Sources close to the multinational giant inform me that it has successfully purchased rival corporation EnProtech of Scotland. EnPro stock had taken a dip earlier in the day as rumors began to circulate, accusing CEO Ollie McTavish of embezzlement. McTavish denied. That's a probably important email right there. Not explain how millions of dollars in revenue ended up in his personal account. All right. I'm sure it was just a clerical error. Cool beans. Let's go ahead and move on here. As transfer of ownership was officially declared. The purchase gives Tai Yong a significant. And hope you guys enjoy. This is Eliza Cass.
Nice place you got here. Where's Megan Reed?
Reed? I don't know.
Stop lying, Sal. I know you kidnapped her and her team. I know you're out to destroy Sarif Industries.
Sarif?
I also know you're working with that son of a bitch who left me to die. So where's Megan?
No, no, you got it wrong. You think I'm behind it all, but I'm not. I'm just like you, the hired help.
You're the head of a billion-dollar megacorporation.
And you think that will protect me, but it doesn't. These men, they're bigger than Sarif, bigger than Tai Yong. I'm nothing compared to their ambitions.
What are you talking about?
Sarif knows. Ask him. He thought he could protect his staff with subdermal GPLs. But these men, they control global interests at a whim. One call to Picus, and the implants couldn't be heard. I thought they'd sent you here to kill me. You've got to help me. Please. You've made it this far. Surely you can protect me. Surely. Surely you can protect me. Men never fail to underestimate women.
Adam, what the hell did you do? The entire building's on alert.
Panic room. She's got a goddamn panic room.
Yeah, well, so do I. Forget about her right now. Get to the hangar bay, fast.
He's in the penthouse area somewhere, and I want him found immediately. He cannot get out alive, you hear me? So comb this area on the double and find his ass. Now!
Yes, sir.
All right, so you definitely are going to need to be patient when you want to go through this. Obviously, look, right now, it would be so easy. And just to even prove to you guys how easy it would actually be, what I'm going to do is we're going to take a cyber energy bar, and we're going to eat it, and then we're going to use our stealth.
Am I the only one who heard that?
Bam. Look at how easy that would be. We're over here now. None's the wiser, and we made a pass without being seen. But we prefer to try to make it as challenging as possible. That's obviously, yes, there are some times where I'll grab the access card instead of sneaking my way through. But I want this to be really, 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 really challenging. So you have to look in their area for them to show up. There will be moments that you will be able to move. It's definitely, you have to have a little bit more patience. So if you're the speed type of person and wants to rush through this, I definitely don't recommend you paying attention to this. So there's a guy coming down the stairs right now. Right there. He is going to turn around. Once he turns around, then this guy here is going to come back this way. Once you see him actually turn around, and the guy that's right there turn around, then you're going to have a moment to actually move up to the next cover. But if you do it any time before then, they will see you. Alright, so now we're about ready to have our moment. And you need to hurry and go from cover to cover. And get against this cover right here. So here, you're pretty much at a safe point. No one will be able to see you from this location. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to get to the next cover, and we're going to wait for that perfect opportunity. So wait for all these guys to turn around. So if we would have moved, we'd have been seen by this guy there. Again, you can play with the time that it takes you to do stuff. You can maneuver, do different things to see if you can get around it, and keep starting the checkpoint to do what you need to do. But I prefer just to be smarter, wait it out. There's no rush here whatsoever for me. Nice. Better be safe than sorry, and we have done it. Congratulations. That is how you do it the boring wait-a-while way. Some people don't prefer that.
Jensen, I'm coming to pick you up. You anywhere near their hangar bay?
I'm heading there now.
Great. Get those bay doors open or this rescue attempt ain't gonna happen.
As you can see, go smooth operator. I keep reading this over and over again. This one's gonna be a little bit more difficult now, so here we go. Gonna go ahead and save. Wait for the camera. Congratulations, you've done it. This is where you actually need that specific augmentation in order to hack robots. And we'll just do that on the way back. Stick to the far side here. Again, you will have to fight these robots if you do not have this augmentation. Which is what the augmentation that we got at the beginning. So go ahead and do some hacking here. It's only a level 2. We cannot get to that, so we know we got to get to the node. There it is. So we go up, down, 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 up, and down.
Access granted.
Congratulations. And we got an achievement too. So this is where you can disable. So activate. Congratulations, you've done it. So is there anything else in this room? I don't think. Now there's all kinds of things you can pick up.
Hangar doors unlocked.
And we'll pick up the EMP grenade. Check out the email. There you go. So now we're going to be heading to Montreal, where we're going to have a big boss fight as well as another very, very stealthy location. Now you'll notice that the game does give you ample means to take out the robots. Pick up some heavy armor, heavy ammo. Remember that weapon I told you that you could get off the one guard? You could pick that weapon up to have for that heavy ammo. Should definitely come in handy, obviously. Now we're just kind of searching around here. Another heavy ammo. So, yeah. There's also other ways to beat the robots. They're on our side, so they're disabled, don't worry. And there you go. I mean, that's pretty much the gist of it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. There's you a rocket launcher. and rockets, of course. So lots of different means for you to take out your targets. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this. I definitely enjoyed trying to figure out the routes for this ghost for not taking any soldiers out whatsoever. That's what's made this walkthrough special. Like, you'll see walkthroughs out there that'll be pacifist and things like that, but not a lot of them out there. Actually, I don't even know if I've seen one out there yet where you don't take a single person out unless it's like a speed run or of some sort. But more heavy ammo, more Typhoon, if that's your thing. Rockets, so much. The game gives you plenty of opportunity to take out the targets. So hopefully you guys enjoyed, and of course, I will see you in Montreal. Let me go ahead and do a quick save here, that way I can load it up for the next one.
Jensen, time to hightail it back to Detroit. Get in.
We're not going to Detroit.
What?
We're going to Montreal. I'll explain en route.
Damn right you will.